What's up, you guys? Garrett here, back at you guys again with another video. And with everyone who's sitting at home right now, I thought, you know, there's probably a lot of people that are looking online and looking for ways to make money. So I thought there was no better time to do a full out beginner's Amazon FBA guide. This guide is gonna be a 5-video series. So if you're new to the channel, be sure to hit that subscribe button so you can kind of stay tuned as we go along through these 5 videos. My goal with this video is to take someone who's completely new, no Amazon FBA experience, is looking for an online business opportunity and kind of show you guys exactly, you know, which opportunities you guys can be taking advantage of on Amazon FBA, with Amazon FBA, how to get started, how each individual business model looks like. And you know, you probably see tons of ads saying do this business model wholesale, do this business model private label. In this series, I'm going to be breaking down each and every business model, how they work, and how you can make money from it. So in this video, I kind of want to break down some common, you know, questions beginners tend to have. You know, is Amazon FBA saturated? Is it too late to start? How do I get started? All these questions will be answered in this video. Amazon FBA has definitely changed my life. I went from working in a warehouse at FedEx making $12.62 an hour to now have been selling full-time for over 3 years, making a great living for myself. So many of you guys out there might be in certain situations. This is a great online business opportunity, not only today, but going forward. So let's get right into the Amazon FBA beginner's guide and let's get this party started. So the first question I get, you know, is it too late to start? A lot of you at home might have been seeing this Amazon FBA thing all around the internet. You've probably seen it on the news. You're probably thinking it's the opportunity is already gone. Too many people know about it. It's probably too late to start and it's not lucrative anymore. But I'm here to tell you that new Amazon sellers are joining the marketplace every day. A new successful Amazon seller is made every single day, and it's definitely not too late to get started. And I'm saying this just because the data shows that new sellers are coming in every single year. $1 million sellers are being made every single year. The stats show, you know, there's more $1 million sellers every year. There's more sellers doing $500,000 per year. And the number of sellers who are able to actually hit these sales goals continue to increase on a year-to-year basis because, you know, Amazon's a growing marketplace. There's tons of opportunity in not only the United States, but, you know, we have FBA going to, you know, Australia, we have Europe, we have Canada, it's in Mexico. There's so many different opportunities around the world with Amazon that all these different sellers are starting to join the marketplace and are absolutely crushing it because Amazon sales revenue continues to grow each and every year. And if you just look back from like the 2000s to now, every single year Amazon has seen extreme growth, which not only gives us as sellers an opportunity, but continues to let us grow our businesses along with Amazon. I'm not sure if you guys actually knew, but third-party sellers like myself make up for more than 50% of all sales on Amazon. So if you're not an Amazon seller, you might be thinking, you know, I'm ordering from Amazon.com, I'm buying this product from Amazon.com, which most likely most of the products you're actually ordering are coming from third-party sellers like myself. So that just shows you the opportunity that's available on Amazon because we're technically getting to partner with the biggest online e-commerce platform in the world, one of the biggest retailers in the world. That's almost like partnering with Walmart. Like imagine having your products in every single Walmart across the country. Well, with Amazon, we get the opportunity to have our products available for sale to everyone in the United States. If we want to sell in Canada, we have them available to everyone in Canada and so on and so forth with all these other countries. So the opportunity is immense. There's tons of different products you guys can sell. So it's definitely not too late to get started. The opportunity is only gonna start to grow as e-commerce gets more popular. The next question I get is, can I get rich quick? With all the advertisements you probably see popping up on YouTube, check out so-and-so, they're doing $600,000 a month. Then check out my other student, they've been able to go from zero to $400,000 per month. Well, realistically, guys, we have to be realistic. You know, Most people who start selling on Amazon are not going to get rich quick. It's a business like anything else. You have to put in the work. You have to learn how to actually run your business. You have to learn how to scale your business. It's like any other business. If you get rich quick in a business, you most of the time got lucky. This is a business where you're gonna have to put in hard work. You're gonna have to educate yourself. You're gonna have to build relationships, and you're gonna have to grow your business. Can you get rich selling on Amazon? Yes, there's tons of people who have gotten rich selling on Amazon. Is it easy and quick to get rich selling on Amazon? No, trust me, I've been doing this for 3 years and I can tell you it's not an easy business, but it's definitely a business that has tons of opportunities if you want to put in the work. Like I said, get educated on the business. There's tons of free content out on YouTube, Instagram, reach out to Facebook groups, ask other sellers questions, really just educate yourself because there's so much free education online here on my YouTube channel, other YouTubers, other social media platforms where you guys can actually go dive into some content, learn how to do the business and get started. And just don't waste too much time looking at all this free content. Get some knowledge and then start taking action, because ultimately you're gonna learn the most as you're taking action, learning the business, actually doing the business. And again, don't get discouraged after 30 days of selling on Amazon. Majority of sellers quit just based on the data. There's probably over half of the sellers' accounts on Amazon barely have anything listed for sale. I know a lot of people I've taught how to sell on Amazon, my friends from high school. They do it for a month or two. They don't really put any effort into it, so they don't really get the results. See me getting all these results and they think it's so easy. They go out, put in minimal effort, minimal, you know, working on their business, and they don't get the results, so they ultimately just quit. So if you're gonna dive into this business, be sure you're ready to work hard and be sure you're ready to, you know, go through the ups and downs of starting a business, because on the other side of that, majority of sellers are going to quit before they get to the good stuff. So if you're willing to push through, work hard, gain that knowledge of selling on Amazon, you will have a breakthrough where you'll start saying, okay, this is getting a lot easier. I'm starting to learn more. It's becoming easier to build relationships. And you'll really just start kind of quickly surpassing all the competition. Next question I get is, can I compete with Amazon on their own platform? Again, like I said, over 50% of all sales coming through Amazon's platform are from third-party sellers. A majority of the listings Amazon does not even sell on. So a majority of the products on Amazon, Amazon's not even selling themselves. Yes, they do sell some products. Yes, they do create up their own private labels, but that doesn't take away from the amount of opportunity that there is for third-party sellers like myself and like you. So don't think that you can't come onto Amazon's platform and be successful just because they're actually selling as well. What I've noticed is each and every year, third-party sales start to outweigh Amazon sales. So even Jeff Bezos said that third-party sellers are absolutely crushing Amazon when it comes to selling on their own platform. So that should just speak mountains for itself. Another great question for you beginners out there is, do I need to live in the United States to get started? And the answer is no, you do not have to live inside the United States to be able to sell on Amazon's US platform. You're gonna be limited to what type of business models you can pursue. You could do, you know, wholesale, where you're ordering from distributors here in the United States, having it sent to a prep center. And what a prep center is they prep your products to be sent into Amazon fulfillment centers. They'll create the shipments and send the products in on your behalf. Now, I don't really like this business model for, you know, people that live internationally. There's just a lot of headaches. You have to set up businesses, you have to get different licenses and stuff like that inside the United States. So it becomes a lot trickier if you live outside the country and you're trying to pursue this business model inside of the United States. The best business model for, you know, people that live outside of the United States is going to be private label. Reason being is you can go up, create your own products, have your manufacturers, whether it's in China or wherever it may be, actually just ship your products directly into Amazon's warehouses. You don't have to have all these EIN numbers, all these different tax ID numbers inside the United States. So it becomes a lot easier for international people who want to sell in the United States on Amazon's platform to actually make that jump and go forward with it. So how do I get started in actually getting up and running selling on Amazon? Well, first you need to open an Amazon seller's account. Now there's two options for you guys when you go to open up an account. There's a free version and there's a pro version. Basically the difference is the free version, you're gonna get an extra dollar fee per every item you sell. and the other pro version is going to be $40 per month. So obviously if you're selling 40 products or more per month, it's gonna make more sense for you guys to just pay that 40 bucks a month, because once you pass 40 bucks, you're gonna be saving that extra dollar fee. Also with the pro version of an Amazon seller account, you're gonna be opened up to a lot more categories than you would be if you had the free account. I don't know why, it's just how Amazon works. Okay, the second thing you have to do once you're starting to get started on Amazon is going to be picking a business model you want to follow. Now, the next four videos in this beginner series, I'm gonna break down the four different business models you guys can be using, but they are retail arbitrage, online arbitrage, wholesale, and private label. You can make money with every single business model, but it's just gonna be depending on your current situation, how much money do you have to get started, what are your current resources, so on and so forth. And the reason I say you wanna pick one business model to get started with is because you don't wanna be trying to do so many different things at first. You wanna learn how to use Amazon's platform. You wanna start getting sales, gain some experience selling on Amazon, and then you can start kind of branching out into the different business models. Next thing is you're gonna have to find inventory sources. Where are you sourcing products to actually sell? Because products aren't just gonna come to you. You don't just snap a finger and you have all these profitable products. You have to find ways of gaining these profitable products, whether that's retail arbitrage, going to all these different, you know, retail stores, finding stuff on clearance, finding stuff on discount, whether that's ordering from brands directly or from distributors, or whether that's, you know, going over to Alibaba.com and sourcing your own private label products. You have to identify a source where you guys can get products consistently so you guys can start selling them and making a profit. The next thing is you have to be able to identify what makes a profitable product, how often does it sell. Again, next videos, we're gonna be going over this type of stuff, but there's different, you know, Keepa charts. You can see sales velocity. You can see average sales price over the history of a certain amount of time. You wanna be able to learn how to calculate Amazon fees to make sure which products you're sourcing are actually profitable. There's a lot of different things that come into play. What are prep costs? How much is this product gonna cost to ship into Amazon? What are the fees? What's my best case scenario? What's my worst case scenario? So you wanna know kind of how all these fees and shipping and stuff like that works. You can then build that into your product cost to see your true profit margin. And the final and last thing is just learning to buy low and sell high. That's the name of the game. That's how you make money in this business. You buy products at a lower cost, you sell them at a higher cost on Amazon, and you make a profit. It sounds super simple and easy, but there's just stuff you guys have to learn and know to be able to actually buy low and sell high. It's not too confusing, but like I said, I'll go more in depth in the future videos in this series. So to describe a little bit more about the four business models, we'll start with private label. Essentially, private label is where you go, source a product from China, you manufacture it, because we identified on Amazon this product selling, and you wanna create up your own brand and your own version of that product. But let's say we're selling a spatula, right? Spatulas are selling on Amazon like hotcakes. We wanna go over to a manufacturer and create up our own spatula with our own branding, our own logo, and stuff like that. What we would do is then launch that product on Amazon, start selling it as our own brand name spatula, and essentially we're building a brand. Amazon has private label brands. I'm sure at your local grocery store you see the generic brands. That's all private label stuff. So that's essentially what we're doing on Amazon. We're identifying opportunities with products that we can sell. We're going and sourcing them, putting our own branding, our own marketing, our own logos, and then we're going and launching it as our own products. The great thing about private label is you're not gonna be competing on the same listing with a bunch of other sellers. You own that product, you own that brand, so you kinda get to control how you're pricing, your marketing, and stuff like that. Next business model is going to be wholesale, where you are selling name brand products. Essentially how this business model works, you're gonna have to have an EIN number, tax ID number, stuff like that to even get started. You're gonna be opening accounts with either the brands directly, with wholesalers, with distributors, and we're gonna be ordering brand name products and selling them at a markup on Amazon. Typically, most wholesale sellers on Amazon are a volume-based business, so they're working on smaller margins, but they're selling high velocity. So the smaller margin gets made up because of how much pure volume they're doing. So this is a business model that kind of requires a bit more capital due to the fact that you're working on smaller margins and you need more money and more capital to be able to purchase these products in volume to be able to make up for that loss in profit margin. Next business model is probably going to be the best for beginners, people with low amounts of capital to get started with, and that's going to be retail arbitrage. Essentially how retail arbitrage works is you're going to retail stores like Walmart's, Target's, we're finding products on a discount and we're selling them at a markup on Amazon. I did this when I first got started. I still do a bit of it today. It's a great business model. You can make a lot of money doing it. It just requires a lot of legwork. You have to constantly go to stores. You have to constantly be sourcing. You're selling ones and twos. The products aren't typically replenishable, meaning you can't buy them over and over and over again. So definitely a great business model. If let's say you have $1,000, if you want to build up that capital pretty quickly, you can start heading out to your local stores, buying products and selling them and making profit. And the last and fourth business model is going to be online arbitrage. And how online arbitrage works is you're purchasing products basically the same way as you would with retail arbitrage, but you're doing it online, like walmart.com, target.com, and there's tons of softwares out there that kind of scan these websites for profitable products. Again, I'll be going into it more in depth in the future videos in this series, but it's a great business model if you're good at, you know, finding discounts, coupons, buying discount gift cards, stacking deals. You can really get kind of creative with it and make a lot of money. It's not my preferred business model just because I'm not that smart of a guy, so I'm not able to go here, stack this discount with that discount. But if you're someone like a couponer and kind of know the game of stacking discounts, online arbitrage can be a great business model because you're not having to go out to the stores. You can save a lot of time sitting at home on your computer sourcing products and either having them delivered to yourself or delivered to a prep center. Well, they'll do all the prepping for you and sending it into Amazon. So you can really scale up quite well with online arbitrage. So guys, I just want to give you a brief breakdown of how Amazon works, the different business models you guys can kind of pursue within the Amazon FBA business aspect of things. The next four videos, I'm going to be going into depth on one video for private label, one for wholesale, one for retail arbitrage, one for online arbitrage. So you're definitely going to want to subscribe and stay tuned, especially if you're a beginner. They're going to be great videos and you'll know exactly what to do and how to pursue each and every business model so you guys can get out there and start making some money. I hope you gained a ton of value from this video. I definitely had fun making it for you guys. Hopefully it helped some of you new beginners starting out, you know, get out there getting your first sales on Amazon and really start making some money for you and your families. But that's gonna wrap it up, guys. I'll see you guys on the next episode of this series. Stay tuned.